The days seem all the same now. The revolution sparked my hopes and dreams. I dreamt of leaving my country and building a better life elsewhere. But that's no longer possible. Anyway, my country needs me. I hear her calling like a mother to her son. It's early morning and the noise of warplanes has woken me. I can hear the sounds of explosions and my neighbor's children crying. It's a bitter reminder of reality and the need to stop dreaming and focus on staying alive. The explosions are getting closer and closer. My brother and I go outside to see what's happening. One of our neighbors is running around hysterically. He's asking if anyone has seen his son. He went to buy some bread. Those around us say the bombs have hit Abu Muhammad's house near the Naim roundabout. We run there as fast as we can to find scattered bodies. One of them belongs to a pregnant woman. Neighbors tell us she was due to give birth in just a few days' time. Then, the noise of warplanes grows louder. One is overhead. We all scatter. It's white, like the ones that hit us a few days ago. A Russian plane. After the planes had all gone, I got up and walked to the shop I work in. My boss, who was quietly sipping tea, gave me a weary smile. I noticed he wasn't smoking. That was very unusual. He usually had a cigarette with his tea, but Daesh has banned smoking now. After smelling his cigarette, they'd humiliated him in front of everyone. Then they beat him up, as if he was a criminal. While we were talking, two men carrying some papers went into the shop next door. Seconds later, they walked into ours. They handed us both pieces of paper before leaving without a word. These were an order from Daesh, banning all televisions in shops. We had a week to remove ours. It seems it wasn't enough to stop us talking to the outside world. Now we can't even look at it either. A little later, a friend came in the shop. We hadn't seen him since he was arrested by Daesh for the fourth time about a month ago. "You're alive!" I shouted. "We thought you were dead!" He laughed with a weird smile on his face. He tells me that the last time he was arrested, it was because his trousers were too long. Daesh insists that they should always be above ankle length. Anyone found breaking this rule has to undergo a week-long Sharia course. Then my mobile rang. It was my mother. She asked me to buy some groceries for the family, but I can't afford much these days. Tomatoes now cost more than 400 Syrian pounds, and rice is around 500. It's terrible. On the way back, I thought up lots of excuses to explain why I'd returned with so little food. But I didn't need to. Like most parents here, my mother was just delighted that I hadn't been arrested or killed and was safely home again.